This quick guide tutorial from exocad will demonstrate in detail the copy tooth feature. Starting with exocad version 2016, the copy tooth step will come after the crown bottom step in the wizard. This feature allows you to mirror teeth from the opposing quadrant, or to copy teeth from the same quadrant. Furthermore, you can decide if the copied or mirrored teeth behave like a pre-op scan model, virtual pre-op, or like a real library tooth, direct copy. Let's start with mirroring a tooth as virtual pre-op. To do this, simply click in the center of the tooth you want to mirror. Then move the tooth to the desired position and set the mirrored tooth with a click. If you want to do the same with another tooth, click the Mirror Copy Another button. Perform exactly the same operation with the next tooth. A simple click on the center is enough. In some rare cases, the one-click tooth detection may not work. If this happens, you can use the Correct tab to manually define which parts of the scan belong to a certain tooth. You can adjust the brush size with Shift and the mouse wheel or with the slider in the wizard. Paint the area you want to mark for the tooth with the left mouse button. Use Shift and the left mouse button to toggle and delete brushed parts. You can also undo your actions or clear the marked area. Click Apply to apply your changes to the tooth. Then position the tooth and set it with a click. For pontics, you will be prompted to select the target tooth of your tooth copy. Click again Mirror Copy Another to mirror the last tooth. Repeat the same steps for this tooth. If you made a mistake, or if you want to change a tooth copy, click the Change Copy of Tooth button. The Select dialog will be restarted, and you can replace a copied tooth by another tooth. Let's try to copy a tooth from the same quadrant. Once you have selected another tooth, click a copied tooth you want to replace. Let's repeat this operation to mirror again the opposing tooth, as a mirrored tooth number 6 looks better than a copied number 7. Click the tooth to be mirrored, and click the tooth to be replaced by this new tooth. Once you have finished the tooth selection, you can adjust the tooth placement already here in the Copy Tooth dialog. If the Move Tooth button is active, you can move the tooth exactly as in the familiar Tooth Placement dialog by using shortcuts. Move a tooth with the left mouse button. Scale a tooth with Shift and the left mouse button. Rotate a tooth with Control and the left mouse button. Scale a tooth in a desired direction with Control, Shift, and the left mouse button. Using the Tilt Tooth button, you can only rotate teeth in buccal lingual direction. Now you can select the next step. Advanced Placement Correction will open the Correct Pre-op Position dialog in the next step. This will again allow you to position every pre-op tooth individually. As we have already positioned each tooth, I recommend to select the placement is fine like this and skip this step. The light blue color of the cloned teeth tells you that they will be used as a pre-op scan model now. A pre-op scan is an additional scan that helps you creating your design. The actual construction is performed the classic way, by loading tooth models. Adjust the tooth placement so that the model teeth are close to the pre-op model. This will lead to better results later on, when you adapt the model teeth to the pre-op scan. You can also use free-forming options to move the model teeth closer to the pre-op model scan. Note, a pre-op model scan can also be a scan from a pre-operative impression or a diagnostic setup. If a pre-op scan is present, the wizard will give you the option to adapt tooth models to the pre-op model scan. Click Adapt Tooth Models to start the adaptation. Model teeth will now be adapted to the scan, little by little. You can see the progress. Once you think the adaptation is good enough, click Stop. The following steps are well known, and they are exactly the same as for an anatomic or reduced restoration. Therefore, we will again start with the Copy Tooth dialog to show the other possibilities of that feature. Here we are back in the Copy Tooth dialog. Now I want to show you some additional functions when mirroring with pre-op model target. You can also copy several teeth at once to a single pre-op model, for example, to quickly copy a bridge. Once you have selected the first tooth, you can use Control and left mouse click to add and select another tooth. This allows you even to select a complete block of teeth for your virtual pre-op. And why not even adding the adjacent teeth? They probably might help us in the placement of the pre-op scan. You can also perform corrections on a series of teeth, but only with the brush tool. Changing the margin, as we'll be seeing it later in single tooth mirroring, is not possible. You can use this brush function to add gingiva parts, for example, to your pre-op scan. Once you have finished to adjust the pre-op area, click Apply. Then position the block of teeth with a click approximately in the required region. When copying a series of teeth, you will be prompted to confirm the target teeth. If all are selected, green, click OK. Now you must select the next step. For tooth blocks, I recommend to choose Advanced Placement Correction, as this will open the Correct Pre-op Model Placement dialog. Here, you can not only position the pre-op model manually, but also use a registration tool to achieve a better placement of the pre-op. Use as many points as you need. Note that the Best Fit Matching feature might not work properly here, as the mirrored pre-op adjacent teeth look completely different from this side's jaw adjacents. The following construction is performed the classic way you should be familiar with: loading tooth models, adapting, and freeforming them. Therefore, we will start again with the Copy Tooth dialog to demonstrate another very interesting feature. Welcome back one last time to the Copy Tooth dialog. Now I want to show you how it looks like when you choose Direct Copy as target for the copied or mirrored teeth. Click again in the center of the tooth you want to mirror. Move the tooth to the desired position and set it with a click. But before I do that, I want to demonstrate another option for performing corrections on the detected tooth with a margin. Note that this is not a required step, as the automatic detection usually works fine. Correct the margin by moving the points. or clear all points and draw the margin manually. Finalize the margin line with a double click. Let's undo all these steps now, as the tooth has been detected correctly. Click Apply to apply your changes. Now, place the tooth and confirm the position with a click. To mirror the second tooth, click the Mirror Copy Another button. Perform the exact same operation with the next tooth. For the pontic, select the target tooth of your tooth copy and repeat all steps to mirror the last tooth. And again, as shown in the first part of this tutorial, you can perform the tooth placement already here in the Copy Tooth dialog. If the Move Tooth button is active, you can perform the placement exactly as you usually do it in the Tooth Placement dialog. Move the teeth with the left mouse button. Scale them with Shift and the left mouse button. Rotate them with Control and the left mouse button. Or scale in one direction with Control Shift and the left mouse button. Now you can select the next step. Advanced Placement Correction will open the known Tooth Placement dialog in the next step. This will allow you again to perform the tooth placement. Alternatively, select The placement is fine like this and skip this step. Now you can perform the placement of the copied teeth as you know it from the real library teeth, and optimize the placement of the model teeth by moving, rotating, and scaling. You will find a more detailed explanation of this wizard step in a separate tutorial. Once you click the Next button, the copied teeth will be adapted to the margin, as it would be done with real library teeth. The Freeforming window provides all known features. You find more details about the freeforming step in a separate tutorial. Thank you for watching this video.